Just let everything take a break as you relax in your chair, as you notice your breath. Just feeling your breath coming in and going out. So I love this new song that is out. It's from an old song, one of our old childhood songs. It tells us that God has the whole world in his hands. And I love just going back to those simple childhood songs that bring out so much truth. And just great reminders. When we look at our crazy world going on around us, it's so important to remember that God still holds the whole world, everything around us in his hands. All the mayhem, all the chaos, all the strife, he has it all under control. In Romans 8:31, it says, if God is for us, who can be against us? And in Matthew 6:26, it says, look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet their heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Deuteronomy 31:8, the Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you or forsake you. So do not be afraid and do not be discouraged. It's easy to be discouraged when we look at what's going on in the world around us, but we know that God is always with us. He still holds the whole world in his hands. So take a few more nice deep breaths here. And then we'll sit tall and we'll start with some big deep breaths. Just drawing those arms all the way up, pressing your palms together in prayer. Drop it down to where your heart is. We'll do that again. Release. Big breath up. Inhale. Bring those hands together in prayer. Drop it down with an exhale. And one more big breath up. You guys, I'm going to move the camera real quick. Position it a little bit. Go ahead and drop those arms down with your exhale. Better. All right. Very nice. Now let's take our hands to our shoulders. Drop your shoulders down away from your ears. So they're nice and far away from your ears. And then we're gonna drop your left ear to your left shoulder. Get a nice stretch in the side of your neck. And we'll go the other way. So pulling shoulder away from the ear, stretching on the side of the neck. Let's come to center and do that again. Stretch out the side of the neck on that right side. Come center and go the other way. Dropping those shoulders down. Bring it in the center. Drop your chin down and look down towards your legs or your feet, stretching out the back of your neck. So again, just keep your hands on your shoulders. Just keep your shoulders dropped. And then bring your chin up and look up, stretching out your throat. And we'll do that one more time. Chin goes down, look down. Focus on the back of your neck here. And chin comes up and look up. And bring it back into center. So we're gonna keep those hands there and then just circle really big with your elbows. So just imagine you're carving out some big circles with your elbows, working into your shoulders, just moving very slowly. Okay, just seeing what you feel and making the circles as big as you can. If you have any areas that don't feel good, just go around them. You can just direct those elbows around those circles or around those areas where it doesn't feel good. Okay, but otherwise, just make nice big circles. And then we'll take one more here. It's really working into those shoulders. We'll go ahead and reverse. So make sure you're using your breath. So you're inhaling as your elbows come up and you're exhaling as you drop your elbows down. Sitting tall, your core is strong, and of course you are breathing. Good job, you guys. Let's take two more big circles. All right, super nice. Go ahead and bring that on back into center. Take your arms out. We're going to cross those arms. So take one over the other, bring it back out to where they were, and then go the opposite way. So the opposite arm comes on top, bring it out and in and out and in. Just stretching those arms out and then crossing. Good job, everybody. Using your breath. Super nice. Just warming up arms and shoulders some more. And then we'll bring it into center. Take those arms in front. Take your palms up. We're going to open, shut, working the hands and fingers. Trying to keep those arms nice and level. And again, keep your core strong. Keep your posture here. Don't slump. Let's take those palms down. Open, shut, those wood hands. Good job, you guys. All right, and then take your left hand to your right, pull your fingers back, open up that wrist. Nice straight, strong arm. We're gonna drop those fingers down, press into the top of your wrist, your hand, anywhere that feels good there at the top with your fingers pointed down. And then we'll go to the other hand. So pull those fingers back, nice straight, strong arm, open up that wrist. Breathing through every stretch, through every movement, we keep breathing. Wonderful job, ladies. Fingers go down. Again, pressing in the top of the hand, the wrist, everything that feels good here. All right, super job. Go ahead and drop the arms down. So we need to come to the edge of your chair. So scooch forward a little bit. We're going to sweep the arms back and then come all the way up. And do that again. Drop the body down. Sweep the arms back. Come all the way up. Just continue to move. Using that breath. Breathing up. Exhaling as you come down. Sweep it back. Inhale up. Body down. Exhale. Inhale up. Great job, you guys. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Let's do three more. There's three. Make them big. And two. Use your breath. And last one, super job. Come on back up, sit tall. You can scoot your hips back. Take your left leg out, just circle out your foot, your ankle. Get a little stretch into your toes. It's easy to sometimes do that in your shoe if you've got enough space in your shoe. Or like I said, you can always drop your shoes off. Let's go the opposite way with your circles. That leg, try to keep it level with your hip. You're working the muscles in your leg too. You're engaging those muscles. Just feel them. They're nice and strong. Okay, let's take two more circles. Drop it down, opposite leg up. Same thing. Circle. Working into foot, ankle, maybe your toes are getting involved. Great job. Notice your core. Remember, guys, you can always hang onto the chair if that helps you to keep your core more strong. Use that as an option. Let's reverse the foot. Circle the opposite way. Super job. Staying with that breath. We'll take a few more. All right, bring it on back into center. So take that left leg up again. We're just going to take a big breath up and we're going to fold over that leg. So if you want to drop the leg down, that's fine. But maybe today you try it up here. And just taking that nice big forward fold, stretching, pulling your toes back. Maybe you want to see what that feels like with that leg lifted as opposed to to on the floor as we often do it. So just taking here a couple of breaths wherever you are. Pulling those toes back, sending your heel away from you. And then we'll gently lower that down, take the opposite leg up, pull your toes back, engage the muscles, take a big breath up, fold over. Again, maybe this doesn't work for you, maybe you want your heel down on the ground, perfectly great too. Just thought I'd give you guys a little option today, try something a little different. Okay, so we're folded over, we're breathing. Always fix your leggings or your pants if they're crooked like mine are. So we'll take a couple more breaths. Pull your toes back, send your heel away. All right, let's drop that leg down. So sitting tall, we're gonna take a nice long stretch to the sides. You can just hold onto the chair or you can drop that bottom arm down. Then we'll go the other way, nice long stretch. Your side body, and then bring it back in the center. So I want you just to float each way. Just float side to side. Go at your own pace. And just imagine you're like a reed in the wind, just floating, moving side to side, just bending, stretching. Great job. Keep doing that. Keep breathing. Nice job, everyone. We'll take a couple more. Just float it side to side, stretching out the side of the body. Super nice. Bring it on back into center. So again, you want to sit closer to the edge of your chair. We're going to lift our heels. Stretch back a little. Lift those heels. Come up onto your toes. Waking up the backs of those legs, those calf muscles in the back. Here we go. Let's do five more, four more, three more, two more, last one. So now we're going to go up onto our toes and then bring your toes up. So come up onto your toes, heels up, and then heels down, pull your toes up. So back and forth. Heels to toes. Good job. Okay, you're sitting tall, maybe the arms on the side, holding onto your chair. It's all good. Wherever your hands or arms feel comfortable. Keep working it back and forth. Keep breathing. Great job. Let's do five more sets. Here we go. There's five and four and three and two. And last one. Good job, you guys. That's good for the muscles around your feet and the tops of your feet. A lot of people get sprained ankles as they get older. They trip or fall. And so it's really good for that area. So good job. Way to go. Let's go ahead and march. So start bringing those knees up. Marching it out. Sitting tall. We're going to float the arms up. Inhale. Float the arms down. Exhale. Do it again. Float the arms up. Inhale. Float the arms down. Exhale. So just continue to draw the arms up with the breath. Exhaling the arms down. Moving those legs. Good job. Be mindful of your core. Let's do five more here. And four. Sweeping those arms up and down. There's three and two. And last one. Drop the arms to your sides. We're going to run it forward. So run your feet forward and back. Forward and back. Forward and back. Keep moving those feet. Good job. Keep it going. Okay, now we're going to take it out to the side. Oops, try not to hit your phone. So run it out to the side. So just making like a letter V with your legs as you run it out and bring it back in. Run it out, bring it back in. Good job. Out and in and out and in. Remember, you can always go at a different pace than me. That's fine. Do your thing. Let's bring it back into center, and then we're going to go back to the front. So run it forward and back, and forward and back. We'll go five more here. There's five, and four, and three, and two, and one. Super. All right, ladies, grab your weights, whatever you have. Bring them on back to the chair. If you feel like shaking out your legs after the leg work, you can do that. All right, and then we're gonna sit tall. We're gonna squeeze those bottles up and drop them down. Squeeze them up and drop them down. Work into your biceps. Squeeze up, drop down. Squeeze up, drop down. Okay, it really helps these biceps to work if you really squeeze those bottles. If you hold them with a loose hand, not as good at work. You're still working it, but not as good. Not as well, I should say. Correct my grammar here. So here we go. Let's go five more really strong. There's five. And four. And three. And two. And one. Very nice. So we're going to now punch it in front. So punch both arms out and in and out. And in. Try to keep it about shoulder level. Remember your posture. Remember your breath. Keep it out strong. Great job, you guys. Awesome job getting to your chair for some fitness today. There you go. Kudos, kudos. Let's go five more here. There's five. And four, press it out strong. There's three, and two, and one. Bring it center, and then we're gonna go up, working into our shoulders. So lift it up, palms facing in. If you wanna add an extra and move your legs, even if it's just a little movement or whatever, you can go for that. I'm just gonna focus on my arms right now. Just breathing. There we go. Let's make it strong. Let's go five more. Four. And three. And two. And one. Super job. All right, so we're going to incorporate all three. If you want to take a break here and just shake everything out, you can do that. So we're going to go to biceps. We're going to punch it out in front, bring it back in, and press it up and drop it down. Go back to your bicep work. Squeeze it up. Punch it out. Bring it back in. Press it up. Drop it down. Biceps. Good job, you guys. Out in front. In. And up. And down. Bicep work. Wonderful. Creating those strong arms, strong shoulders. Using your breath. Your posture. You know, remind us of that a lot because it's easy to forget and start to slump. I am often guilty. You guys are doing great. All right, let's go five more sets. Here's five. Your sets can be different than mine. That's okay. It's four. Just keep breathing. And three. Wonderful job. Here's two. Keep it strong. We're almost done. And last one. Very nice. All right, let's go ahead and take those weights down. And come back in the center. Shake out those arms. We're gonna breathe it up, and just like we did before, just sweep it back. Sweep those arms all the way back. Body comes down. Breathe it up. Exhale, sweep it back. Just release anything in those arms. Breathe it up. Exhale, body down. And one more time, breathe it up. And exhale, body down. Okay. Great job, everybody. Go ahead and stand up. And we're gonna just take a big breath up here. So just take a big breath up. And then as you exhale, just sit it down, float the arms down. Looks like this from the side. Big breath up. exhale, float it down. Inhale up, exhale down. Take it up again, but we're gonna stay here. Take your arms high and then drop your arms in cactus. Okay, so your arms are in cactus and lean back. And just take a nice little back bend here. It doesn't have to be big, just whatever feels good for your spine. Okay, you're opening up the chest, letting the shoulders fall back. Maybe you press your hips a little bit forward if that feels okay. We'll just take a couple more breaths here in this nice little back bend. And then bring it into center. Great job, everybody. Take your arms high. You're going to make a fist. Hopefully you can see I've got a fist there. And we're going to stretch over to the side. So you're going to stretch out your side body. And then come center. And go the other way. Try to keep everything in the same plane. So you're not leaning forward. You're not leaning back. Try to keep everything in the same plane here. You're just leaning to the side. Stretching out the side of your body. Awesome job, you guys. Bring it back into center. So again, we're going to float the arms down, sit it down. Breathe it up. Exhale, take it down. Inhale, take it up. Exhale, take it down. Inhale, take it up. And then we'll drop those arms down. So I want you to take your feet wide. We're going to go into our squats. Okay, so your feet are wider than your hips. Toes are pointed forward. Okay, if it feels better for you to point your toes out, that might be a little better on your knees. Try that. Hands in front like you have a big hammer. We're going to hammer down and draw it up. Hammer down and draw it up. Okay, so just sit it down and take it up. You're squatting down, hammering down, and then all the way up. Exhale, take it down. Inhale, take it up. Breathing up. Good job, you guys. If you want to take a break, take a break. If you want to just do the arms or just do the legs, that works too. So nice. Those really strong quadriceps. This works your glute muscles. We want strong glutes. That helps us protect our lower back. Let's go five more. Here's five. And four. Three, and two, and last one. All right, super job, everybody. Go ahead and release. You can shake all of that out. We're gonna come to the, switch this over, side of the chair for a little balancing pose. So holding on to the chair, ground your foot next to the chair, ground your leg. Make sure it's straight and strong. Everything is rooted down into that foot, right? We're going to bring up the opposite leg, bring up your knee, flex your foot on that lifted leg, outside hand on your waist. Okay, try to keep that inside leg nice and straight and strong here. Okay, we're going to go for five. We're going to hold it for five. Oh, and don't forget your focal point right in front of you. Find a spot to focus on. So there's five and four and three. And two, and one. Okay, now drop your knee down so it's still holding on the chair, and you can turn sideways if you want. We're going to do our quad stretch, which is also a bit of a balancing pose. So if you want to take your foot in your hand, and if that's not available, just send your heel back or grab your pants. Okay, so whichever way works for you. Find your focal point. And see if this time you want to maybe take your hand off the chair just for a second or two, and then drop it back down. Okay, don't have to. If you want to just keep your hand on the chair, that's good too. Okay, so again, you're focusing on one spot, something not moving. Okay, so not your cat or your dog. Here we go. Let's count from five and four. And three, and two, and one. Wonderful. All right, shake it out. Come to the other side of your chair. Do the other side. So again, just holding onto the chair, grounding your foot next to your chair and your leg, bringing that out Inhale, side leg up, flexing your foot here, hand on your waist. Okay, we're going to focus on one spot. So just breathing here, and maybe this time you want to try taking the hand off the chair. It's up to you. You don't have to. Okay, it all depends on where you're at today. None of us can see you because we're all focusing on our one spot, right? So just do what you want to do here. Maybe play with it a little bit. Go for five more. There's five and four and three and two and one. See if you fall out of it. It's totally good. You can just laugh at yourself like I do. So let's do our standing quad stretch. So you're going to ground that foot next to the chair. You can turn sideways or not. And then you're going to bend that knee, send the heel back, send the foot back. Take the foot in your hand if you can. If you can't, maybe grab the pants, or again, just send the heel and the foot back. Okay, find your focal point. Find your breath. So maybe this is good. Maybe you just stay here. Perfectly great. Maybe you want to play with it. Maybe you want to take that hand off the chair. Maybe not. It's whatever you feel like doing it. Maybe this side is different than the other side, and that's okay. You're not symmetrical people. You're very asymmetrical. So let's focus at that one spot. Let's go for five more. There's five and four. Three and two and one. All right, super job. Yeah, you guys, come to the back of your chair, holding onto your chair. We're gonna bend one knee at a time and just keep ourselves in the rear end. Sometimes we need that, right? So just kicking yourself, bring that heel up on each side, shifting from leg to leg. Right. Here we go. We're going to go five more sets. There's four more. And three more. And two more. And last one. Good job. Hopefully you felt that in your quadriceps. All right. So back to our chair. All right. Super job, you guys. Let's take those arms overhead. And then float the arms down halfway. Take an arm in. Take opposite hand to opposite shoulder. Just dropping your shoulders down. Giving yourself a little hug here. Really nice. We'll release. Take it back out. Do the opposite arm on top. So again, hand to shoulder. Dropping your shoulders down. Giving yourself a nice little hug. Good job. We all need a little hug these days, right? Good job, you guys. Way to go. All right, so we're going to grab, release that. We're going to grab our weights one more time. We're just going to do a little more arm work here. Take your arms out to the side and just turn your weights side to side and draw the arms in. Okay, so you're working into those wrists. As you turn your weight side to side, draw the arms out. Let's go back in. Breathing. Take it back out. If this bothers your shoulders, you guys can always stop. You can always adapt. You can always adjust. Take it back in. Working into those wrists. Take it back out. Great way to strengthen your wrists. Do it one more time. Take it back in. And take it back out. Nice job, you guys. Float the bottles or your weights down to your side. And then we're going to lift, down, and lift. And this works your deltoids. So these muscles right here on the outsides of your arms, coming down from your shoulders, really good to strengthen those to create those strong shoulders. Here we go. tall, breathe into it. Hope you guys are having a good day. Temperatures are coming down. We have to love that here in the desert. Such a great thing. Thank you, Jesus. All right, let's see if we can do five more. And if you guys want to bend your elbows, that might take a little stress off your shoulders if you're feeling that stress. Here's five. You can go this way too. And four. And three. And two. Last one. Beautiful job. Drop your bottles, your weights, set them aside. Just roll up those shoulders really big. Just release all that stuff into your shoulders. Just loosen all that up. Let's go ahead and go the opposite way with those shoulders. Of course, remembering to use your breath. Inhale up and exhale as you drop your shoulders down. Super nice. Here we go. There's five. Four more. Three more. Two more. And last one. Very nice. We're going to lean back in your chair, so you might want to turn sideways. You're going to take your hands to the back of the chair, scoot your hips forward. And you can take your legs out. We're going to lean back and open up the chest. Breathing into the chest. Take four or five breaths here. Just really squeezing your shoulder blades together. Make sure you're extending your crown of your head away from your shoulders. Okay, you don't want to crunch into your neck here. You want to extend the neck. And take two more deep breaths. And then come center. So we're going to go the opposite way. So we're going to bring the feet in and just slump over your body here. And just bring your body down and feel that nice grounding now in your spine. And we'll take a few breaths here, letting your head hang. And then come on up. So keep your back rounded here. So your hands are on your thighs now. You're going to really round your spine. So drawing your belly button in. Your chin is dropped towards your chest. We'll take a couple more breaths here. All right, let's go ahead and come on up. You guys are doing great. So nice. Great job. Let's do some stretches into our legs. So we're going to take that left leg to the back. So scooch to the side of your chair. Take your left leg all the way back. Working on your hip flexors here. And remember, the more you take that back foot back, the more stretch you're going to get. Okay, maybe leaning into this. Maybe leaning back. A deeper stretch. Take your breath. Let's take a few breaths here. Just kind of let this stretch happen. One more breath here. All right, and then bring that outside leg forward. So we're going to go into our little hip stretch here. So scooch back to the center of your chair. And with your left foot or ankle on the opposite leg, making your triangle shape, we're going to lean into that. And remember, you can always drop that to your lower leg. Okay, they both work. So you're looking down. You can always press in if you want a little deeper stretch here. Just listening to your body, seeing what's going on here. We'll take a few more breaths. All right, we'll come on up. So we're going to do that other side. From the other side of your chair, take that outside leg back. Walk it back. As far as you can. Okay, so just find your positioning here. And maybe leaning back, forward, see what works well. So important to stretch out our hip flexors, especially if you guys like to hike. I don't know if you guys like to hike, but really important to stretch out your hip flexors before and after hiking, especially after they get super tight. If we let stuff like that go, if we do it a lot, it can eventually cause injury. If we take care of it each time, we're, we have a much better chance of staying ahead of that curve, not getting those injuries. So we'll take a few more breaths here, working on those hip flexors. All right, way to go, everybody. Go ahead and bring that outside leg forward. Come back to the center of your chair. We'll go for that nice stretch into that outer hip there. So making your triangle shape, whether it's up here or down here, we'll lean into it, looking down. Maybe using your outside hand to press into that leg. See what you feel. Maybe leaning in a little bit more as you go. Maybe going a little bit deeper into your stretch. That's always a good thing. Just listen to your body. We've got a couple more breaths here. Wonderful job. Go ahead and come on up. So sitting nice and tall, we're going to take a big breath in. Reaching up to the sky, take your big exhale, fold over, draw the body up, inhales all the way up, big exhale, big forward fold, bring it down, body comes down and then drawing it back up one more time here, big breath up, inhale, big forward fold, exhale, we'll stay here with our head down. Allowing the head and the neck to relax. Using your breath, releasing your spine. We'll take a couple more breaths here. And then we'll come on up. Bring it all the way up. So you're gonna bring your back to the back of your chair. Scooch those hips back. Just let everything relax here. Maybe stretching your legs out a bit. We'll take in one more big breath. So a big inhale. And a big exhale here, just releasing with your exhale. Allowing everything to relax. Feel the heaviness in your fingertips with your arms at your sides and your fingers reaching for the ground. Feel the heaviness and the relaxation in your hands. And then your lower arms and your upper arms all the way up to your shoulders. Relaxing the shoulders. And then just feeling your body relax. Your chest, your belly, your hips. Your lower, mid, and upper back. Just feel your entire torso relax. Just feel it soften and become more heavy. Noticing your upper legs and just allowing your legs to relax all the way down to your ankles. And then into your heels, the soles of your feet and your toes. And even noticing the tops of your feet and just fully allowing both feet to fully relax. And then just finding your way back all the way up to your shoulders and your neck and your jaw, and allowing all of that to relax and release and surrender. Just let the jaw drop down as you let the mouth and the tongue relax. And then focusing on your facial muscles, your cheeks, your eyes, the muscles around your eyes and your forehead. Just allowing all of that to relax. And then allowing your entire head to relax. Just think of the full circumference of your head, allowing everything to relax. Noticing your breath again. Beautiful breath. Just so thankful. We're so thankful that God is still in control. He is still sovereign. He is still on the throne. And he still holds the whole world in his hands. Ephesians 1:11 says, in him we have obtained an inheritance, having been predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will. So I heard Corey Ten Boom speak in an interview once from years and years ago when she was still alive. And of course she experienced the horrors of Auschwitz. And she said something very profound, which was that God has plans. God does not have problems. And I just love that. And I think that's something to remember through these crazy days that we're living in. God has plans. He does not have problems. So let's take a moment here just to rest and breathe and reflect on what God tells us. Job, everybody. Let's go ahead and bow our heads in prayer. Dearest Heavenly Father God, we are so thankful that you do hold the whole world in your hands, and we're so grateful that we have that comfort and that we have your word, and that you tell us you are always with us, you never leave us, you never forsake us. We're just so grateful for who you are. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end of all things. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for dying on the cross for us. We can never thank you enough for taking away the punishment of our sins. And thank you for these beautiful women. I pray this time together has blessed them from the inside out and from top to bottom. And I pray that you keep them healthy and safe, and keep their families healthy and safe. We love you, Lord, and we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. It's in your holy and very precious name that we pray. Amen and amen. Thanks, you guys. God bless you.
Oh, that was good.
Thanks.
So good.